I owe a lot of you an enormous apology for lots of confusion yesterday regarding the IDW video. I had an enormous screw up. I haven't done anything quite this stupid on my channel in about 4 or 5 years, I believe. I do record things and upload them before they're actually supposed to go live, and I accidentally earmarked this IDW follow-up video based on an article from Bleeding Cool that was following up to all the craziness going on there that was really making the situation worse regarding new cost reductions, new structures, new responsibilities being placed on the editors that I thought was really interesting information and explained why IDW was going to get so much worse. I earmarked it to go live at the wrong time. So I ended up having like a double upload. There was no name, no title to the video. There was no thumbnail. And I caught it pretty quickly. There was like maybe 250 people had seen it. And I deleted it. I was like, damn it, that's supposed to actually go up on Sunday or Monday. So I re-uploaded it, but I didn't re-upload that video. I actually re-uploaded the IDW video that I had done from earlier in the week, I think from on Thursday when it had gone live. And everyone's like, hey, this is a repeat. I was like, come on, you know, 250 people saw it. Why are you guys busting my balls? But it wasn't that one. I had actually re-uploaded the one that had gone live that I never deleted, that had a thumbnail and a title, and I made it an enormous cluster error trying to be hasteful in getting it re-uploaded and rescheduled at the right time, and I made a big mistake. I want to apologize for all the confusion because it was a very interesting article, and I'm going to have to re-edit everything because after I had done all that work, I went and deleted everything that I had done for the past 2 weeks. All the like files for the editing that I had done has also been deleted. So I have to go and redo this thing from scratch. So I'm going to include this in here with a very heartfelt apology, especially to like Nate. And I think it was Chris. I think his name was Chris. Was the one that finally was like, look, listen, dumbass. No. This isn't the second one that you tried to upload and then you deleted, because I saw that too. This isn't that one. This one doesn't have the Jason Aaron information. This one doesn't have the new editorial responsibilities and all that stuff. And I feel like a complete dumbass because I am. And this is the real information. I'm going to re-upload it. An enormous apology to anybody that I might have been sassy with. If I got too much sass on me in my replies to you, I thought people were being unfair. But no, you were just pointing out that I was being a dumbass and didn't realize that I myself had made an enormous clusterfuck, which doesn't happen all that often. But thank you very much for calling me out. And next time I'll pay a little bit more attention. And I won't waste your time. I apologize so much. Please forgive. It's tough if you're a comic book reader and you're interested in some of the IDW properties. Outside of TMNT, they just don't do a good job. And quite frankly, on TMNT, they don't do a great job there either. You know, I like The Last Ronin. That thing's awesome. I really like Saturday Morning Adventures. Untold Destiny of the Foot Clan was fine. But, you know, the ongoing TMNT series was really bad for quite some time. We'll see what Jason Aaron does with that. But with the information I'm about to show you, it's likely Jason Aaron will not be on IDW's TMNT series for very long. I would expect within 6 months, he's off the book and they announce somebody else is going to be coming in there, because all the garbage that IDW are producing, and that's most of what they are producing, it's not good stuff. They don't have a lot of good talent out there. It's about to dry up and actually become worse. It's about to become complete dog shit. IDW CEO Davide Jonas has appointed himself publisher of IDW. Jonas is pushing to bring the cost of books down, especially on licensed titles at the publisher, looking to get every page of a comic for $200 to cover writing, penciling, inking, coloring, design, and editorial all in. The belief is that if creators are paid less, they will be more incentivized to promote the books to earn more as part of a new back-end deal. What that back-end deal is, I'm not really sure. I haven't heard from anybody that's reached out and said, you won't believe it, what IDW have done. It's groundbreaking stuff. They're paying me less, but the royalty opportunities on the back end on the licensed product are through the roof now. And while it might not be great in the short term, long term, you know, this could be a real game breaker. I have not heard that from anybody, but apparently that is the idea now. So typically, a good comic book artist is going to be more than $200 a page. Now, obviously, IDW can't really afford a whole lot of good comic book artists. They have some really good artists on the TMNT that they're launching now, but it's a new artist every single issue. To get down to $200 a page, including pencils, inks, colors, lettering, writing, editorial services and design all in per page is absolutely ridiculous. You will never, ever be able to hire a talented person. You will never be able to hire somebody that used to be talented but isn't anymore with those kinds of rates. And they're already obviously bottomed out. If you go look at the Star Trek line, which obviously they don't have the budget as they do for the TMNT comics, especially the mainline book, you're getting writers like Colin Kelly, Jackson Lansing. You're getting Christopher Cantwell and other writers that are even more obscure than them. Basically, they already can't afford to hire anybody good when it comes to writing. There are no artists of note on those Star Trek books, and somehow they're going to squeeze it even more. And this is insane. We're talking, if you're the penciler, $60 a page if they're paying you also to ink it at those kind of rates. And the colorist and the letter and everything, like, their rates are going to go through the floor. And we know that the rates really haven't gone up in the industry in like 20 or 30 years as is. And IDW was already notorious for being penny pinching and never really paying a face rate to begin with. But they're going to sell you one on the dream. You could write a TMNT book. You could write Star Trek or something like this. And it's absolutely crazy, like, this belief. Well, if we only pay them $20 a page, they will be financially incentivized to have to go out there and do all the marketing themselves. Otherwise, they won't have enough money to eat. That's the dream IDW is selling. And IDW Publishing under Davide Jonas, who is apparently now taking over as the publisher of the company after Mark Doyle was let go. There's also some rumors about Mark Doyle and why he was let go at the very end of this. And it's not funny because it's clearly not true. But what they had to make up about Mark Doyle, because apparently he's such a nice guy, they couldn't make up anything like damning about him, is funny. Now, it's only going to get worse. So we know the rates are going to bottom out and they're not going to be able to hire any talent, including likely TMNT books themselves. Editors will work more as brand managers and will cover a range of books. So if you are the editor of Godzilla, you are responsible for all of that brand and edit the book solo with no assistants or junior staff. Expect a number of assistant editors to be moved or to move on. And if the books don't sell, well, IDW has one person to blame, and that's the editor. Yes, that's right, because IDW is just notorious for having the most professional, really competent editorial staff in the entire industry, even though they literally just got rid of all their competent people that they have. And so if you're an editor and you're like a senior editor or something, you're like, you're in charge of Star Trek, all of it. You're going to have to edit all the books solo, no help from anybody else. You're going to have to go out there and find all the talent. You're going to have to hire the writer, hire the artist, keep them on point to keep up with their deadlines and everything so you can actually publish the book on time. I can't believe everybody hasn't quit yet. It's like, the amount of shit that would be on just an editor's plate at that point would literally be overwhelming. But apparently that's the new strategy to cut overhead costs. And the worst thing about this is, for the most part, IDW Publishing isn't what's killing IDW. If it was just a comic book publisher, they wouldn't make a lot of money. They might lose a little bit of money sometimes, but they wouldn't be in this shape. But because they decided they were going to be a media brand, and IDW Media, you know, we're going to have all these streaming shows, which don't exist anymore. They had like three or four cracks at it. None of them worked because they didn't have the IP to do it. And it's been this enormous financial drain on the entire company to where everybody is just completely screwed if you're dumb enough to actually stick around. If you're the TMNT editor, you're going to be doing TMNT. You're going to be doing Mutant Nation, Saturday Morning Adventures. And there's always going to be like two other miniseries going on at least just to cover the cost of the license that you've paid for. Like, you could end up working like 16-hour days at this shit company and just being eviscerated by comic book fans because you literally don't have the human capability to do all of this stuff well, just being one person, not having a team whatsoever. Now, mentioning TMNT, that is their one big success as of late, but it does come with an asterisk. The Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles relaunch did excellent for IDW, even better than the last Ronin series, selling about 300,000 copies, and the Turtles outsell everything in IDW, but IDW had to pay a pretty penny to Paramount to keep the license and bet the farm on it. They will likely have to do the same next year for the Star Trek license, but it is notable that Skybound's take on Transformers and G.I. Joe Snatch from IDW in recent years have performed far greater than IDW was able to achieve. That's right. It's the rumor that everyone's heard. No one's heard the exact figure that IDW had to overpay to such a degree to actually keep a hold of the TMNT license. And that's likely why you're seeing all these firings. That's why you're seeing all these cost-cutting measures, because they had to literally pay out the ass just to keep it, because it was the one successful franchise that they had left. You know, once they lost Hasbro, once they lost Star Wars, once they lost Marvel Action, you've got Star Trek, you've got TMNT, Godzilla to a degree. I guess you still got Sonic, which isn't doing bad, but it's not like it's a perennial top-selling book or anything like that. But the cost involved with actually maintaining and keeping the license for TMNT apparently is overwhelming, and that's why we're going to be getting at all times like 5 TMNT books for the foreseeable future, and that's why we won't get any, you know, good talent on it. And this is why I don't believe you'll see Jason Aaron on TMNT past whatever contract that he had. Maybe they signed him up for 9 issues. Maybe they signed him up for the first year. If they did, once that's up, he won't be coming back, because for $200 a page all in, they can no longer afford Jason Aaron. They probably can't afford a writer like Ryan Parrott. They won't be able to afford even writers like Christopher Cantwell or Colin Kelly and Jackson Lanzig. What are Colin Kelly and Jackson Lanzig going to do? Make $12.50 each a day writing a fucking TMNT book? That doesn't even cover lunch in New York or LA or wherever those guys live. And it's absolutely insane. And if you look at what Skybound did, you know, with their Hasbro license and obviously relaunching Transformers, really setting up the relaunch of G.I. Joe, which I think a lot of people are excited for, did they penny pinch? Did they cut back on the talent? It seems like they opened their wallet up and said, you know what? One of the ways to get people excited, not only just because it's Transformers or G.I. Joe, let's bring talent in. Let's go get Daniel Warren Johnson. Let's get Joshua Williamson. Let's get Tom Riley. Let's get some really talented people and put them on these books. And obviously, you have good creators, you get good creative, you get good comic books, you end up with great word of mouth, and now you have books that are performing better than they have in decades at this point. The exact opposite approach, one of them is successful and one of them is going out of business. Now, regarding Mark Doyle, I do not find this funny, because it's not funny that he lost his job. But I do find it humorous what they've had to say about him as to why he lost his job. I'm sorry, Mark. You didn't deserve this. Official complaints were made about Mark Doyle's behavior at last year's Eisner Awards for being what is described as overly tired and emotional. It's also rumored there were previous complaints made by a number of staff members before his departure. However, Doyle was visibly butting heads with IDW CEO Davide Jonas at the time, trying to protect certain talent and editorial staffers against imposed cuts. So they decided to trash the guy's name and put a few rumors out there about why exactly the devious Mark Doyle was let go, despite being one of the few talented people that they actually had left, because Jamie Rich had already gone. He was tired and a little emotional at those Eisner Awards, and we just couldn't handle that. Tired and emotional, that's the big complaint. Oh, and there were other complaints, but there's nothing specific about them. You know if it was like sexual harassment, they would absolutely say that. You know if it was an inappropriate work environment relationship or something like that, or he was screaming at people or abusing his authority, those words would be in there. Like, no, people complained about him. What was the complaint? That he wanted better work? That his standards were too high? I'm sorry, but you're going to need to use spell check better on this, Mrs. Ontos, on your fucking Star Trek book. You know, you forgot a period here. There should be a comma. You misspelled 5 words in this comic book. Well, goddamn that, Mark Doyle. He's a slave driver. He expects excellence from everything that we do. So the way that they went out in public and smeared the guy, he was overly tired and emotional at the Eisners. Can you imagine that? Somebody wins and he's dropping a tear. Like, this fucking guy, we gotta get rid of him. Look how emotional he is. He's excited for somebody winning. Or maybe he's like sitting there at a boring part and like, why is he so goddamn tired? That fucking Doyle, he's always tired. But apparently he's such a nice guy, they couldn't even make up lies about him that even sounded like he should have been fired at the beginning. Obviously, the reason he was fired is because his vision of how to make a comic book and Davide Jonas's vision on how to make a comic book don't coalesce. Davide Jonas wants to bring it down to $200 a page, all in, including art, writing, editorial services, design and all that stuff. And Mark Doyle was smart enough to be like, you were out of your mind. You can't even afford homeless people to do that. They would want more money than what you're actually offering at this point. So I hope Mark Doyle lands on his feet and gets a good job. He does have a good reputation in the industry, although they are trying to soil it there, I guess, saying that he's too tired and emotional at award ceremonies. But there you go. More crap from IDW. If you're a fan, expect the comics book. Expect your comic books to get far, far worse in the not too distant future as these changes are made and all the good people that were competent are shown the exit. And that's been happening for quite some time at this point. If you appreciate a little bit of honesty to the comic book industry and you would like to support our mission here on Think Critical YouTube, to provide that honesty, I do want to invite you to come visit me on Think Critical Patreon. There's a link in the video description. And if you do support me there, I will give you awesome bonus material, all kinds of podcasts that you couldn't believe, extra videos, polls, all that kind of good stuff. It's all there, all in on the Patreon.